So, I want us to see some prophecies. First of all, I pray that may God take care of everyone living in and around the surrounding of Buya Mountain, especially this December. If God can make this December to pass away first before anything happens, then it will be my joy. Yes. Then secondly, Yaoundé, a roundabout around Yaoundé, with God's guidance and protection. Guide and protect them during this era of Christmas, during this December period. But what I really want us to see now is a prophecy concerning South Africa. While we're singing, oh, the glory of Jesus, I saw Jesus on the cross and his blood was flowing from the cross. It was falling precisely on Egypt, the nation Egypt. So, by that vision, God is asking for us to pray for his mercy upon Egypt. we are still here to know. But we are going to pray for Egypt, for God's mercy to fall upon the nation Egypt. You know, that's where the 10 major cults, or cultism, the 10 major cults that are spread all over the world to thousands and millions of minor other cults is stemmed from Egypt. The end is coming. We need to pray for Egypt. There are some things that need to be disorganized and arranged again. And for things to be arranged, sometimes there must be some kind of disorganization. Things need to be destroyed for things to be fine for the country, especially for the Christians, for the sick of the Christians in the country. So we need to pray for God's mercy. Whatever that might come to pass, whatever that might happen in the future, it shouldn't touch the human race. Yeah, it shouldn't touch the human race. The London Clock Tower, Big Ben. London Eye. I don't know, this is a sign. You know, that London Clock Tower, that Big Ben, that Big Ben is the spirit behind that tower. So, if there is a collapse or there is a fall, it's just a sign to show that very soon, England, UK, as I said that, in the last prophecy, they'll be losing sovereignty over their territories around the world. That's what I said last time. So we really need to pray. Okay, let me come for precisely a prophecy concerning South Africa. Satan wants to use South Africa as his seat, as his throne. He wants to use South Africa as his seat, as Satan's throne. Thinking through South Africa, he can afflict every other African country with darkness so strong. So, South Africa, we need to pray for South Africa. Because if this succeeds, there are some countries like Zimbabwe, Kenya, Uganda, Ethiopia, there are some that will be touched. This darkness will leave from South Africa and touch these nations. We really need to pray. And this darkness will even touch Croatia. Croatia, I think it's in Europe. Oh, yes, also touch Croatia. So, I'll be reading from Revelation chapter 2, verse 13. I know where you live. This is Jesus speaking directly to the church in Pergamum. A message to the angel, to the man of God who was the leading head of the church in Pergamum then. The Asian church. I know where you live. There where Satan has his throne. You are true to me, and you did not abandon your faith in me. Even during the time when Antipas, my faithful witness, was killed there where Satan lived. I pray for true ministers of God in South Africa. And if these demons in agent form, they are working out their evil plans now to endorse South Africa in this darkness. When you endorse South Africa in the darkness, don't try to carry it out of South Africa to another African country. Or else you and your cohorts will drink in its fullness the bitter waters you are trying to brew in the whole of Africa. Remember, Africa is in the promise, just as countries like Turkey is in the promise. You don't just touch Israel and go free. In the same way, you cannot just touch Africa too and go free. So we really need to pray. South Africa needs intercession, the intercession of God. God's mercy upon South Africa and Egypt. Amen.
Amen.